Hello everybody, today we are going to start a new point from the chapter circles, okay. The name of the point is cyclic quadrilateral, okay. So what is cyclic quadrilateral? That we will see in short. Afterwards we are going to see theorems which are depend on the cyclic quadrilateral, okay. We are going to study the properties of cyclic quadrilateral. Cyclic quadrilateral we see. Here ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. About this figure we can say ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Means all the points, all the vertices of quadrilateral ABCD are on the circle, are on the circle. Understood? So A point A, B, C and D are on the circumference or on the part of circle. Understood? So we can say quadrilateral ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, so cyclic quadrilateral has some properties. Okay, so we are going to study all the properties through the theorems. Okay, so first theorem, important theorem. This theorem is in class 10th also, and properties we are going to use in the sums. So see carefully what is the proper theorem number 1. Prove that the sum of either pair of opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral is 180 degree. Okay, what they are asking? Prove that the sum of either pair of opposite angle. Okay, here about quadrilateral ABCD, angle A and C are opposite to each other, angle D and B are opposite to each other. Okay, so what they are asking? Sum of either pair of opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral is 180 degree. Okay, so here first we will mention given things. What is given? In given, they have given us cyclic quadrilateral ABCD. Okay, cyclic quadrilateral ABCD. Okay, now what we need to prove? Angle opposite, either pair of opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral is 180 degree. Means we have to prove angle D plus B is equal to 180 degree. So to prove angle D plus angle B is equal to 180 degree. Okay, then or angle A plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. Okay, either pair of opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral is 180 degree. So this is our target. Understood? Already construction I have done. Only quadrilateral they have given us. Construction what I have done? Join AC and DB, which are the diagonals of this quadrilateral. Okay, so that we need to mention here. So construction, join AC and DB. Okay, join AC and DB. So AC and DB are the diagonal of this cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, so with the help of these things we are going to use, we are going to give here proof. Okay, so now we will think about the proof. Now see, first we are going to think about AB. AB is the chord of circle. AB is the chord of circle. And we know that angles in the same segment are equal. Angles in the same segment are equal. So here first we will mention AB is a chord of circle. Chord of circle. Okay. So AB is the chord of circle. Then we can say angle ACB, this angle. Angle ACB and angle ADB are equal because both the angles are in the same segment. Understood? And we have seen a theorem which is related to this. Angles in the same segment are always equal. Okay. So according to that, we can say ACB angle ACB is equal to angle ADB. Here reason, angles in the same segment. Okay, so angles in the same segment are always equal. Now we are going to think about chord BC. Okay, so BC is also a chord of circle. Chord of this circle. Given circle. Understood? If BC is the chord of circle, okay, so now we can say BAC, Okay, due to BCC, two angles are formed, BAC, BAC and this, BAC is equal to BDC, angles in the same segment. BC is the common segment for these two angles, okay, because due to BC, see here initial point is B and here end point is C. Here also initial point is B and through D end point is C. So these both angles, this angle and this angle is equal. Okay, so with the help of same reason we can say angle BAC, angle BAC is equal to angle BDC, angle BDC. Okay, angles in the same segment, in the same segment. Okay, so this is I am saying first one and this is I am saying second one. Okay, now as usual we will do addition of both by adding first and second. Okay, so here I am taking by adding 1 and 2 by adding first and second. Okay, so here we can say angle ACB, angle ACB plus angle BAC, ACB plus BAC. Okay, so that I am taking here angle ACB plus angle BAC, ACB plus BAC is equal to angle ADB, ADB plus angle BDC, plus angle BDC. Okay, we have done LHS plus LHS, RHS plus RHS. Okay, so ACB plus BAC is equal to ADB plus angle BDC. Now if you will see here ADB, ADB we see ADB, this angle, plus BDC, BDC, this angle. If we will do addition of these two angles, which angle is formed? ADC. So instead of this, we can write angle ADC. Once again, see carefully. What is given? ADB, ADB means this angle, plus BDC, this angle. The sum of these two angles is forming angle D. So we can write angle ADC. Okay, so here I have taken angle ADC. Here angle ACB plus angle BAC as it is. Okay, so now what we can see, angle ACB, ACB means which angle? This angle. BAC, this angle. Okay, if I am thinking about this triangle, which angle should I write here? Which angle should I add here? That time angle sum property we can use here. This is taken, this is taken, so I can write here angle ABC. But I cannot add in only LHS, I need to add in RHS also. Okay, so by adding, see, this I am taking here angle ACB plus angle BAC plus, okay, which angle I am adding? That angle ABC, angle ABC is equal to angle ADC plus the same angle I am adding this side also, angle ABC, both the sides. Okay, same part we have added, same angle we have added in LHS and RHS, both the sides. Okay, so here see angle ACB, ACB means this, plus BAC means this, plus ABC, ABC is equal to this. So this plus this plus this, this is a triangle. So sum of these three angles will be 180 degree. We can write sum of these three angles is 180 degree. So what is getting here? Angle ADC plus angle ABC is equal to 180 degree. See, ADC, ADC means this angle, ADC means now this angle, plus ABC, ABC means this angle. The sum of one pair of opposite angle is 180 degree. Okay, so we got this one thing, angle D plus angle B. So we can write angle D plus B. Angle ADC means what? Angle D. Angle ABC means what? Angle B. So D plus B is equal to 180 degree. Okay, so this is we have received here first result. Okay, now what we can do, we know the sum of all the four angles is 180 degree, oh, sorry 360 degree. According to the angle sum property of quadrilateral, what we can say, four angles, angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D is equal to 360 degree. So that I am taking now here angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D is equal to 360 degree. Okay, so now angle D plus B we have, what is the D plus B? 180 degree. So that I am taking here angle A plus angle C, I am taking here angle B plus angle D is equal to 360 degree. This sum is equal to 180 degree. Okay, so from 1 we can say, so angle A plus angle C plus 180 degree is equal to 360 degree. So we can say angle A plus angle C is equal to 360 minus 180, that is 180 degree. So angle A plus angle C also 180 degree. So we have received the second thing also. So A and C are also opposite angles. So here we can say sum of this angle plus this angle is equal to 180 degree. Okay, so this is very important property of cyclic quadrilateral. Sum of opposite angles of cyclic quadrilateral is 180 degree. This we are going to use in the sums. Okay, see here once again, the next same theorem is in class 10th, which is very much important. So study here only properly, then you will not give, we can save your time in class 10th. See what was the statement is given, cyclic quadrilateral is given and we have to prove this. We have taken diagonals, then ACB and ADB, angles in the same segment, that property we have taken, angles in the same segment are always equal. Okay, with the help of this we have said here, BAC is equal to BDC, ACB is equal to ADB. Then we have added first and second. Okay, whatever results we have done. These all the results we have done on the previous results. Okay, so all the results or all the properties are connected to each other. So by adding first and second we have done here, ACB plus BAC, and this sum of this is angle ADC. Okay, so we have taken ABC in both the sides. ABC we have added in LHS and RHS. So this is now satisfying here angle sum property. So sum of these three angles is 180 degree, ADC plus ABC as it is. Okay, so ADC and ABC means opposite, one pair of opposites angle sum is 180 degree. So by angle sum property we have here, we have taken angle sum, here we can write angle sum property of quadrilateral. Okay, so according to that, when you will put here B plus D is equal to 360 degree, so that time you will get angle A plus C is equal to 180 degree. Okay, so sum of opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral is 180 degree. So solve this theorem in your notebook. Okay, so see here, our second theorem is, if the sum of any pair of opposite angles of quadrilateral is 180 degree, then the quadrilateral is cyclic. Okay, before this, just now we have seen, if sum of two angles, opposite angles, is 180 degree, then quadrilateral is cyclic quadrilateral. But now it is given, if the sum of any pair of opposite angles of a quadrilateral is 180 degree, then the quadrilateral is cyclic. Okay, that we need to prove. Just now you have seen what is cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, so in given things, what we can write in given, what is given, if the sum of any pair of opposite angles of a quadrilateral is 180 degree. Okay, so here what is given, quadrilateral ABCD in which angle B plus angle D is equal to 180 degree. Okay, sum of any pair of opposite angle of a quadrilateral, any pair, so we can use either B plus D or C plus A plus C. So B plus D is equal to 180 degree. Now what we have to prove, then the quadrilateral is cyclic quadrilateral. So to prove quadrilateral ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral, quadrilateral ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, that we need to prove. Okay, only what is given, angle B plus D is equal to 180 degree. Okay, so in proof, for some time we will consider that quadrilateral ABCD is not a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, if quadrilateral ABCD is not a cyclic quadrilateral, then what we can say, here C, suppose C, B, here A, and when it is quadrilaterally cyclic, if point D is on the circumference, like A, B, C, okay, A, B, C, D, all the four points are on the circumference, then we can say quadrilateral A, B, C, D is cyclic quadrilateral, okay. But we will consider that quadrilateral A, B, C, D is not a cyclic quadrilateral. Means maybe this we will think about point D. Maybe point D is outside. Maybe point D is here outside like this. First figure is drawn, or maybe it is inside of the circle. Means any one point from the four points is not on the circumference, then we cannot say that is a cyclic quadrilateral. So here what we can consider, if possible consider quadrilateral ABCD is not a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, so produce AD. So AD intersects D1, okay, on the circumference. Okay, in both the conditions, see, if AD will produce, then it is intersecting on D1, or when D point is outside of the circle, when D point is inside of the circle, then too when AD will produce, that time it will intersect at D1, okay, on the circumference. Means now we can say here about this quadrilateral, we can say ABCD1 or D dash is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, about this figure we can say ABCD dash is a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, so if it is cyclic quadrilateral, then just now we have seen the property opposite angles, sum of opposite angle is supplementary, addition is 180 degree. Okay, so here we can say angle ABC plus angle AD dash C is equal to 180 degree. Okay, if it is cyclic quadrilateral, then we can say sum of this and this is 180 degree. Okay, because D1 is on the circumference, okay, B is on the circumference, A and C, and so this is a proper ABCD dash is a cyclic quadrilateral. So here we can say B plus D dash is equal to is equal to 180 degree. B means what? Angle ABC, and D dash means what? Plus angle AD dash C. Okay, so is equal to 180 degree. So this is, I am saying, first one. Okay, so this we will say first one. Now, what is given? Angle B plus D is equal to 180 degree. B plus D means what? Angle ABC plus angle ADC is equal to 180 degree. Okay, so this is second one, and which is given? Okay, angle ABC plus angle ADC is equal to 180 degree. Okay, angle ABC plus angle ADC is equal to 180 degree, that is given. But we have considered that quadrilateral ABCD is not a cyclic quadrilateral. If it is not a cyclic quadrilateral, we will not get any one point will be outside or inside of the circle. With that consideration, we have done this. ABC plus ADC is equal to 180 degree. So now what we can do, sum of these two angles is also 180 degree, and these two also 180 degree. So from 1 and 2, if you will compare them or equate them, so what I will get? Angle ABC plus angle AD dash C, this is equal to this, angle ABC plus angle ADC. Okay, so ABC, this will be cancelled. Angle ABC from this side and from this side, it will be cancelled. So what is remaining here? Angle AD dash C is equal to angle ADC. Okay, this we got. Okay, but now if you will think about the figure, what is given? AD dash C means this angle is equal to ADC. This angle and this angle is equal. They are, according to this, it is coming. But if you will observe figure properly, then we can say here, see, AD dash C is the exterior angle for this triangle, for triangle CDD dash. AD dash, this is the exterior angle. Okay, and exterior angle is always equal to the sum of interior opposite angle. Means definitely D dash, this angle D dash is equal to angle D plus angle DC D dash. Okay, this is equal to this plus this. But according to this, it came this angle and this angle is equal. So this is not possible. This is not possible. This is contrast to the exterior angle property. So we cannot say this angle ADC, AD dash C is equal to ADC. When it is possible? When it is possible, when D dash and D coincides. Okay. It is possible, see, exterior angle property, exterior angle property, this angle, this angle is equal to the this two. Okay, means we can say angle A D dash C is equal to angle ADC plus angle DCD dash. Okay, but here suppose I am saying this is third one. Okay, but from third angle AD dash C is equal to angle ADC. Okay, it is getting, but from third AD dash C is equal to ADC. Okay, this is not possible. This is possible only when D dash and D coincides. Okay, when D dash and D are same point and on the circumference, that time only it is possible. Okay, so we can say quadrilateral ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Quadrilateral ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Got it, everybody? This is also very simple proof, but we need to change the position of point D. Understood? Thank you.